Hello everyone, my name is Dr. Evelyn Lucas Perry. I am the Director of Public Policy Research at the American Dental Education Association, known as ADEA. Today I'm going to talk to you about the career opportunities and possibilities after dental school. And this is pretty much a surreal talk for me because only 4 years ago I was graduating from dental school and was faced with the same opportunities and where to go with my career. So hopefully this presentation will give you a brief overview of some of the opportunities that dental graduates are able to take advantage of. So before we get started, let's just kind of give a brief overview, and it's really dental school, right? So there's a lot of activities that are going on during your 4 years of dental school. Of course, USC is only 3 years, but there's a lot of resources that you can find on the Go Dental website that talks about the courses that you will take, the community service activities that are available, student-led activities. In addition to the type of environment that dental schools have to offer, which includes interprofessional education, so learning with learning with and from another healthcare professional or student, and then also the diversity inclusion. So there's a lot of things that go into dental school, right? But when you're finally done with dental school, it's over. And so when you're done with dental school, you're like, okay, what next? Where do you go from here? And so let's talk about that right now. So most dental students, once they graduate, the majority go into and stay in general dentistry. So general dentistry, 80% of dentists in our profession are general dentists, and 20% are specialists. And you can get more information about the different specialties if you look throughout the Go Dental website. So most states allow dental graduates to immediately practice upon graduation, but some might opt to do a residency program or a specialty program, or go into another education program like getting their master's or PhD. So a residency program for general dentistry includes an AEGD, which it stands for, the acronym for Advanced Education in General Dentistry, or a GPR, which is the acronym for a general practice residency. So general practice residencies are hospital-based, while AEGD residencies tend to be more so in the dental institution, or more so affiliated with the dental school. So the other opportunities, if you wanted to go and specialize, are to go into a specialty program, which you can get a certificate or a master's program, and then some have the opportunity for specialists to go and pursue their PhDs. So traditionally, most graduates, after they graduate from dental school, go into private practice. And this is what you're probably most familiar with, is the private practice setting. And to just give you an idea about private practice, most dentists are in either a solo or a group practice. So solo practice meaning that you can own your practice, and group practice meaning that you share it with another. Now dental graduates, when they graduate, the majority become an associate, meaning that they work for a dentist at a dental practice, and then several years after that they might buy the practice or another practice. But there are some dental graduates that right after dental school they do go and purchase their own practice. So when you think about that, most dental graduates go on to be an associate dentist, and so there's a lot of opportunities that they have in private practice. This goes for both general dentistry and specialists. So the next opportunity that dental graduates can take advantage of is academia and academic dentistry. So academic dentistry, not a lot of people might actually consider this, oh wow, I can actually be going to academia as a career, but it's actually a really fun and interesting and diverse career that you can have because you can do a lot of different things. So you can be involved in teaching in the didactic courses, so more so the science-based anatomy courses that dental students have to take, or you can be involved in helping dental students and teaching them their clinical skills. So that means you're helping them treat patients. Now, if you're in academia, you can also be involved in the administrative side of dentistry. So administrators tend to be like directors or deans, where they are chairs of programs, where they oversee the administrative aspects of a program. And also like maybe coordinating with community health centers to set up extramural clinical rotations for students. So there's a lot of different opportunities for within academia. And remember, there's 66 dental schools right now in the United States, and each one has the academics have an opportunity to, you know, teach. They can also do administrative work, and then they can also practice, because a lot of dental schools have a faculty practice. The other thing to think about when it comes to academic dentistry is it's not something that you necessarily have to do full time. So per se, there's a lot of dentists that work in private practice that might teach one or two days a week at a dental school. So there's a lot of flexibility that can happen. The other thing that you should know is that within academia, our dental schools are really the powerhouse for a lot of oral, dental, and craniofacial research that's going on. And so academics can be involved in both basic public health and clinical research. So that really gets in next step, or the next opportunity, which is dental research. So there's a lot of different things that dental researchers can do and different environments that they're able to practice in. So you can have a dental research career at, like I mentioned, a dental school, but you can also be in a government agency. You can work within a private, for-profit organization, or in a dental research institute. So there's a lot of different ways that someone can perform dental research. In addition to private practice, dentists can be involved in dental research and performing clinical trials. So don't think that just because you're in private practice that you can't be involved in dental research. But dental research is so key to our profession, because it's really the heart and soul of who we are as professionals. That innovation and knowledge really informs our clinical and knowledge base of how we treat and manage the diseases of our patients. And so this is a key part. Now, the main institute and the main body that really oversees the oral, dental, and craniofacial research is the National Institute of Dental and Craniofacial Research. It's called NIDCR, and it's an institute within the National Institutes of Health, which is located in Bethesda, Maryland. So there's also opportunities for dentists to have a career at the NIDCR. So the last one that I'll talk about is service in the federal government. And so this can be decided either before or after dental school, actually. So some students might look and know that they wanted to pursue a career in the federal service. And so they might have signed up to get a scholarship within the Army or Navy or Air Force or Coast Guard, or they might have decided to get a scholarship through the United States Public Health Service, USPS. So there's a lot of different opportunities, and like I said, the United States Public Health Service, the Army, Navy, Air Force, and Coast Guard have positions for dentists, and they're located within the U.S. and also around the in other countries. And it's a great opportunity for you to give back to your country, and also to be able to travel around the world and pursue a great career in dentistry. So that was just to give you a real quick snapshot about the future after you graduate from dental school. Like I said, just because you choose one career doesn't mean that you have to stay with it. You can do parts and pieces. Like I said, you could be in a dental school and still have a private, you could be an academic and still have a private practice side, or you could maybe go into the Air Force and be in the Air Force for several years and then transition out and go and become a professor at a dental school. There's a lot of different diversities in addition to other career paths, such as working for a nonprofit organization. You can work for a dental insurance company. You can work for other organizations. There's a lot of different aspects. You could be a consultant. There's a lot of different opportunities. As long as you keep your eyes open, you make great connections, take full advantage of your dental school career, because so much of what you're exposed to and who you're able to meet and be mentored by comes from your experience within dental school. So really being a great student, learning how to connect with your patient and knowing about the different opportunities is a first step to have a great future in the career of dentistry. Thank you so much, and thank you for listening. Again, more information can be found at the Go Dental website.